In this question, we are given that a horizontal disk, which is free to rotate about its vertical central axis, is initially at rest. We can see this disk in the figure. And at a distance r from the axis, a coin is placed on the disk and the friction coefficient between the coin and the disk is mu. We are required to find the angular speed at which the disk should be rotated so that the coin will start slipping. In this situation, in the solution, we can state when the disk is rotating at an angular speed omega, this coin will start revolving in a circular path of radius r at the same angular speed omega. And initially, when omega is rest, certainly we can say that the coin will be at rest because of friction. And if it is rotating at omega, the coin will experience a centrifugal force m omega square r in the revolving reference frame. And this centrifugal force will have a tendency to pull the coin outside. But friction will be acting on the coin in inward direction, and this friction will stop coin to slide in outward direction. It will prevent a sliding of coin. So we can say one coin is at rest on disk. The friction on coin must be balancing the centrifugal force acting on it. As angular speed increases, the centrifugal force will increase, and obviously along with this friction will also increase. And we know that the maximum limit up to which the friction can increase is mu n. Here the limiting friction can be written as mu n, and the normal reaction can be directly written as mg because the disk is horizontal. So here we can say the coin will slip when friction is equals to mu mg. Or we can write mu mg is equals to m omega square r. Here m gets cancelled out and we get the angular speed omega as root of mu g upon r. So this is the angular speed which is required to slip the coin. Or this, or we can also say angular speed is more than or equal to this value, the coin will slip. That is the answer to this problem.